There's some big changes coming to the sunscreen aisle. The Food and Drug Administration announcing new rules that officials say will simplify choices while eliminating bogus claims. Or that's the goal. According to these brand new rules, the agency will require sunscreen makers to test their products against two kinds of harmful rays from the sun, not just one of those. Those are the so-called UVA and UVB rays, and who knew they weren't doing that already? The rules will also force companies to stop marketing their products as waterproof or sweatproofs, or sweatproof, because the FDA officials call that those exaggerations. Gee, you think they won't wash off? And bottles of sunscreen with a sun protection factor of 15 or lower will now carry a warning label that they won't protect against skin cancer. Joining us now, Dr. Philippa Cheetham, a surgeon at Columbia University Medical Center here in New York City. What do you mean they won't help prevent cancer? It's better some sunscreen than no sunscreen, no?
Absolutely, but that's not the whole picture. And, you know, the key with sun protection is that you stay out of the sun in the midday strong sun, that you probably should wear barrier clothing. You know, there's certain people with skin conditions who need to be extra careful in the sun. And so the problem with sunscreens is that we don't use enough of it. And we know that the recommended amounts that you should be using, we use only about a half to a third. And if you're in the water, you need to apply regularly. So I think that this is good news.
Yeah, all right. Now, one of the things that they're claiming is waterproof or sweatproof is a load of it. And anybody who's ever done an activity, I mean, if you're out playing football or swimming or anything, playing tennis, you know that the junk washes off like anything else would.
Absolutely, and there is variations between different sunscreens. Some are very thick, and, you know, you end up with that sort of almost like barrier coverage.
Gross.
Other sunscreens, especially the newer sprays, they're very light, and if you're sweating, they wash off, so they do need to be reapplied.
So the thick, gross stuff that doesn't allow you to throw a ball or catch a ball, that stuff is the good stuff.
Well, it doesn't necessarily mean that because it's thick, you've got full protection against UVA and UVB. And the new rulings by the FDA, what they're trying to say is that rather than say this is waterproof or sweatproof, it tells you how many minutes you can actually be in water while you're still getting protection.
Ah.
So I think this is much better for the consumer and much safer.
And one of the things that I've learned from sitting in this chair for so long is that the biggest problems happen with kids who are severely sunburned. And for parents, this is a lot more important than it is for us adults because we get to make decisions for ourselves. Those little kids don't.
That's right. And I think also it goes back to the whole issue that it's not just about spraying on a high SPF factor cream and thinking that that's going to allow you to spend even longer in the sun. And I think that often gives people false reassurance because they think, OK, I've got factor 60 on, therefore I can stay out in the sun and I'm protected. And unlike if you were wearing, say, factor 10. So I think that, you know, that's the key issue, that you still need to take these other precautions.
Like barrier clothing, clothing that doesn't allow the sun through.
That's right. Staying out of the midday sun and, you know, going in the shade. And if you're fair-skinned or if you've got young skin, you're at increased risk.
All great ideas. Dr. Philippa Cheetham, thank you.
Thank you.